Hi, welcome to the one and only Anneka Honor Show. For those of you who tuned in last time, my guests were Mr. Will Johnson and Ms. Siam Herlock from the feature film Amina. On the sofa with me today, I have two very talented actresses from the film Amina. They are Ms. Nicole de Silva Semedo and Princess Abiye Tobin Smith Okusonye. So both of you, welcome to my show.
Thank you.
Thank you.
I'm so honoured to have you both here.
It's a pleasure to be here.
For those of you who don't know, Princess Abiye, her career spans across TV, film and theatre. She burst onto our screens many years ago in a series called Everyday Lives. She has lots and lots of things planned and also has played many leading roles. So Princess Abiye, thank you for joining us.
Thank you for having me.
She plays the Amina's mum in Amina, and that's why we're here today. So can you just talk me through the role itself in Amina?
I played Amina's mum, which is Rachel, and it was a really challenging role because it's a role that builds or breaks the film, because it's like something that builds the film itself. I mean, I had a good relationship with my daughter. We're quite close, I would say. But then I've got this husband that's quite funny, but at the same time, too strict. So sometimes I find it hard to get through to him. So I would rather pretend everything was okay just to avoid the problems.
And of course, we did notice, having seen the film myself, and your relationship with your husband, I mean, that's quite an interesting relationship that you had, because we don't actually see any physical violence in itself. Can you just talk me through, you know, just the relationship itself and the fact that did you feel threatened at any point? How did you feel with that?
I think it's more of an emotional thing. I mean, he wasn't physically abusive, but the way he was doing things makes you, like, you're just scared because you don't know what he's going to do the next minute. One minute he's happy, the next minute one little thing could just trigger everything, you understand? And I remember in one of the scenes where he was sending Amina out, and I was trying to like beg to see if he will accept her to come back in, and he just said to me, listen, you either go with her or you come in. And for me as a mom, it was really a breaking point. But I didn't have a choice, I had to come back. I know I'm not happy about it, but I had to come back. In fact, he dragged me in. He was really physical then, yes.
Yes, well, clearly we will touch on your relationship with Amina, but I'm just moving on to Nicole over here. So I've got Nicole de Silva on my left. Now, Nicole is a model and a dancer. So, Nicole, how did you get into acting?
Well, I used to be a model. I stopped modelling about a year ago. I'm a lot more focused on dancing at the moment. But in terms of acting, I did drama at college, like how normal people do. But when it came to this role, Christian contacted me on Facebook to do his dissertation project.
On Facebook?
Facebook, yeah. So I thought, yeah, it's a good challenge. Like, I missed acting, so I thought, yeah, I can give it a try. But when he actually decided to then take a step further and say, okay, I want you in the actual feature film, that's when I was a bit apprehensive and nervous and scared.
Of course, I mean, it must have been a real job for you as well. So what were you apprehensive about, you know, having to take on such a large role as Amina, as the younger Amina?
I think for me it was acting with people that I established in the acting career, and I had just come from nowhere, really. I have never done this before. So I did say to Christian, like, are you sure you want to use me, because I don't know if I can handle all of this? And he believed in me, so I thought, I think that's what kind of pushed me into
it. Absolutely. Nicole, I've seen you in action. I think you did an absolutely blinding job.
Thank you.
With that. So before we move on to your relationship with, well, to Amina's relationship with her mother, do you know what? How did you prepare for, you know, the acting role itself?
For just the role in general of Amina?
Yes.
I think what helped me the most was the fact that I was scared and I was insecure, like, about my acting skills and alongside these big actors. So I thought I can use that to my advantage in playing such a young role. Like, I was 20 at the time, so playing a 16-year-old, I used that to my advantage, and I just thought if I just channel that through my character, that should work.
And there were some very key moments as a 16-year-old. It touches on pregnancy.
Yeah.
Okay, let's just take a look at you in action.
I didn't do anything like that. It would just be in my everyday life as you see a pregnant woman. I just observe how she acts, how she stands, how she sits down, how she stands up, just general things. So that's how I tended to prepare for the
But you've really executed it very well indeed. Well done. No, great stuff. Mm-hmm. So back to Amina's mom. Can you just talk me through your relationship with Amina and also any moments where you had any real turning points?
With Amina, I mean, we clicked the moment yet. So, although we're filming as mother and daughter, it's a film,
yes.
But it felt as if she was my daughter. And we had that relationship. We had a relationship.
Nice bond.
Yeah, we had that bond from day one. You understand? And we were like encouraging each other. I used to say to her, don't worry, you'll be fine. You know, so I used all that to my advantage. And I'm a mom myself, so use some of those experiences of having young children in the house and the relationship in the home. So I use part of it in the film with her.
Definitely. I'd say that even now, it feels like I'm still her daughter, to be honest. Because we clicked instantly, we had that connection. Like some of it was acting, but some of it was genuinely just us being us.
Do you feel that it makes it easier and it also brings the character more to life to have such a close bond?
Definitely made it a lot easier. Yeah. Especially with so many sensitive issues that we were dealing with, mm-hmm. It really helped to have that connection because that's what you're looking for, as like Amina was looking for.
Mm-hmm. So, Nicole, in terms of Amina's relationship with her father, can you just talk me through that? Because obviously there were some really challenging moments.
In terms of Amina's relationship with her father, he talks and I listen. It's just how it is. He's very strict.
Is Amina scared of him?
Very. She's very scared of him. She tries sometimes to like challenge him, but she can't. He wasn't a violent dad, but the way he just had this presence that just his look, you just have to obey.
Of course, and obviously, playing that particular role, do you think that there are many teenagers who can identify with young Amina?
Definitely. I think a lot of teenagers that go through, that people that I speak to and stuff, when they grow up with strict parents, like they can relate to this. Sometimes we sit down and we talk about, you know, how it used to be and how parents are now, and it's interesting.
Suppose I had an emergency. Should I wait for permission before calling 999?
Since when you think you can backchat me?
Since I was with my friend and you're making a big deal out of it.
Then make this as clear as daylight. Your friendship with this white girl is over from right
now. She's your only friend. I
Amina! Amina, a feminist.
What is going on?
Look,
why can't I have a say?
Stop your eyes.
More to Amina, how did you prepare for your role? What's your process, I guess, when you get a script?
Oh, my process. Well, obviously learning the lines and trying to fall into a character. I mean, for me, playing the mom to a 16-year-old, that was understandable. But then playing that role with the big Amina, it was another thing, because I couldn't imagine myself being a model's mom.
Of course.
I mean, in reality.
Definitely.
But I'm sure with all the makeup, and then what I had to do was I had to watch some videos of elderly people or more mature mothers, how they behave, the sort of movement and everything, so I can put that into the character again. So it's like moving from one different character of a younger mom to an older mom again.
So. Abiye, I think you did an excellent job, and let's just take a look at you in action.
What are you doing here? How are you, Amina? Amina, we tried to raise you up.
By throwing me out and leaving me for the dead, right?
Amina, you got yourself pregnant. You let your father down. You let me down, Amina.
What are you doing here?
Amina, I love you. You're my daughter, Amina.
You're not my mother. You're not my mother! You are not my mother! Don't you ever call yourself my mother! How? How can she call herself my mother? You're not my mother! You are not my mother!
Two amazing actresses.
Thank
that being the transition was just perfect. Absolutely superb. So I have to ask you both a very key question. How did you both feel working with really big established actors? I mean, you know, you have one of the most successful Nollywood actors on the model, as you rightly said. In this, you have Will Johnson as well, who's a, I guess you call him a superstar in the UK. So how did you feel? Did you feel that you learnt a lot from them?
Yes. I mean, working with this crew, I learned a lot, you know, it was really professional. I think this was my first professional movie that I've been in. So it gave me that, I was favoured to work with them. And I was given the opportunity that I've been looking for in a very long time without having to, how would I put it? I was favoured, look at it that way, yes. You know, I learned a lot of things that I probably didn't know before, I picked up from working with them.
And what about you, Nicole?
I would say the same thing. I'd say it was a very big privilege to have worked with such big actors. And for me, what helped a lot is that they were all so welcoming. They knew that I wasn't an actress, they knew that I was a dancer, and they were all like, yeah, you're gonna be fine, like, you're doing a good job, and they like give me some advice. And I think that during the short process that I was doing this film, I've learned a lot from these people, definitely.
So what next for Princess Abiye? What projects do you have in the pipeline?
Do you know what? I'm so excited. There's just lots of things happening. After Amina premiere, I've gone to the movie called International Game.
Fantastic.
Yeah, that's another
International Game.
Yes. And I featured in a TV series. It's going to be an international TV series called Caf Afrique. Yes.
For the audience.
Yes, that's we've done the pilot and that's coming out very soon. I'm really excited over that.
Can you tell us any more about it?
No, you need to watch.
Okay, we'll have to tune in.
Yes. But then in that one, I played the owner of a restaurant, so the boss. So I'm.
Yes.
And then I've got a husband that is misbehaving, so I'm going to keep him in
place.
Perfect.
Yeah. Very different to Amina.
Yes,
great.
Very different.
Good stuff.
Yes, and lots more actually.
Brilliant. Well, we definitely look forward to it. Yeah. And Nicole, what about you? Now you've dabbled into acting. I wouldn't even say dabbled. You've undertaken such a substantial role in a film that's held to be one of the greatest British Nollywood collaboration.
To be honest,
what next for you?
to be honest, I don't think it's sunk in yet. I don't think I've realised what I've got myself into. I think even the premiere, it seems unreal. It's a real like red carpet stuff like this. This is stuff that I never thought I'd be doing. So
well, it's happening. It's happening.
Yeah. That's all I can say. I'm just like, I don't know. It's not there yet. I think what, like when it comes to the day, that's when I'm going to be like, oh wow, yeah, it's definitely happening. I'm here.
And speaking of the day itself,
yeah.
Now I know we have some special designers. Mm. Do you just talk me through, you know, how you'd be preparing for it and, you know, maybe what you'd be wearing?
I don't think I'm going to disclose
that. Ah, okay.
You know, we'll see that on the day.
But there are some designers on hand who will make you look absolutely gorgeous.
Thank you.
Not that you aren't.
You are, of course. Thank you.
But on the day, there'll be lots of glitz and glamour.
Oh, thank you so much.
Thank you. Yeah. Brilliant. Well, it's been an absolute pleasure talking to both of you. And then thank you once again for joining me on my show. Wish you both the best of luck
in the film and
after the film, of course.
Thank you.
So there we have it. Nicole de Silva and Princess Abiye. So next time, join me on the Anneka Honor Show and stay tuned with SRTV.